I think it's the good time to start now. I will just wait 1 2 seconds. Okay. And my name is Fiorenzo Lenzi, and I'm Global Product Manager for Composite Inforol. And today we are going to present some recent developments in composite for aircraft interiors application. I'm going to present this with my colleague, Dimitri Meyer.
Hello, everybody. I'm Global Product Manager for High Voltage Insulation and the mica specialist of the Fonrol Group.
So I'm going to share the screen now. Hope you can see this well. So today we focus about Fonrol and the aerospace footprint, and I will go through some main innovation we did in the cabin interior markets, which are specifically related to next generation filler for honeycomb core, to a new generation of epoxy-based prepreg, and Samica Fireproof, which is a special mica composite especially designed for fire protection of composites. So for those that are not very informed about the company, Fonrol is a global holding established in 83, based in Switzerland and counting about 1,000 employees. We have a global operational and sales footprint and focus on three core markets: the high voltage, low voltage, and the composite market. In relationship with the composites, we position ourselves as high integrated manufacturer, so we can provide from resin to final composite products in the form of rigid plate, 3D parts, machined parts, or prepreg. And we have five different production sites working on composite. Three of them are based in Europe, and two of them are in US. We serve a various application in this field, from industrial application to battery to automotive, and last but not least, and pertinent for today, is the aerospace business. So we have a our aerospace footprint has been really established several years ago around the use of machined parts. Our qualified products are used on many planes, and they are primarily serving two main functions. One is for fastening element in honeycomb panel, where we see the Vetronite TGS 619 as the main product. And we also supply composite panels for the electrical cabinets, where the electrical characteristic and the mechanical performance together with the FST are the key performance for this product. We also have a range of phenolic product which we can supply as prepreg or as panels, and they are widely used for trolley application or for galley at the same time. So when we look at the application for next generation cabin interiors, really I want to bridge what they are, the traditional application and market of Fonrol, with what we have currently in developments for addressing new segments into this field. We have recently worked on core filler material and on a prepreg in order to satisfy the demands for several segments into this field, from the floor to the ducts to the walls, and not excluding the seats part. We also have new developments in the related to mica, where we see application as fire barrier protection and for insulating batteries for current and next generation electrical planes. But let's start really about our innovation and what we can really bring today. So really what is new is regarding new epoxy resin systems, which have special features. They are anhydride, halogen, and solvent-free. They have very long shelf life. They can allow for ambient temperature storing condition for several weeks, and they satisfy the possibility to process them in a very fast way, so to short really the full production cycles for parts, while at the same time satisfying the heat release and FST requirements for the FAR 25853. These systems can somehow find their final applications into two main product portfolio. One which is related to the core filler material, and the second which is related to the prepreg part. So let me start with the core filler material. For those that are not very familiar, this is a resin that is used for potting application, has to be very lightweight and has at the same time to have good balance between density and compression strength. It's a product that, although is not new in the market, is often used as two component system. And really the advantage for this product is that this is one single component system and at the same time has very long handling life and the storage possibilities at room temperature, at the point where this allows really the product to be used for enabling automated potting operation and keeping the extrusion rate, which is really the key features for this product, very high for very long time frame when the product starts to be used in robots or or in cartridge. So really the extrusion rate and the possibility to use this product for automated condition is the key value for this material. And you see here a video of a demonstration that was built using a pumping system coming from Viscotech and in collaboration with Airborne. You see that the extrusion rate is very important for increasing the throughput and then the transfer of the potting in the Onecomp cell. And we think this really position these materials one of the few materials that can enable automated potting and at the same time storage outside the sub-zero conditions for this material. So coming to the second part of this presentation related to the prepreg part, today we think to have developed a resin system which is quite versatile and somehow can be used and tailored around the four different applications, which are the floor panels and cargo, where of course you need to combine the toughening part with the FST part, the ducts parts, which is really designed for having very low smoke density material and at the same time very low flame propagating parts. And also can be tailored for using in application where heat release is very important. So not only just sealing, lining, and bins, but also for monolithic part and sandwich part for the seat structure. So for sure, all around this proper portfolio, we think that the main features and the main goal was actually to bridge what are the traditional benefits of epoxy system, like the fact that they are relatively stable in ambient condition and they can provide some affordable solution, including very good surfacing quality, with the traditional benefits of phenolics, which on the other side have a very low cost structure and also they exceed in terms of FST and fire retardancy behavior in general, especially when it comes to the heat release performance. And all this, let's say, merge actually found a very good place in the characteristic of the EP220 prepreg, which is what 4ALL see today as a solution for phenolic replacement. The benefits are clear. Comparing to phenolics, we have reduced the health and safety issue. We don't use any halogen. The volatiles are not released during the part manufacturing, and this will translate in better surface quality and reduced part cost manufacturing in general. Also, this solution can allow for designing lightweight parts. Why this? Because of the intrinsic improved mechanical performance of epoxy versus phenolics, which express themselves especially in terms of improved sandwich flexural strength and improved interlaminar shear strength. So in the last part of my webinar, I want to introduce and to spend some words also around our recent innovation, which is around the use of mica. This is very traditional business for all. This is why I use product for all the high voltage and low voltage business. But more and more we see application of this mica and concept and technology to composite industry. Very common now is the use for battery protection, and maybe some of you have also had the chance to look at our presentation yesterday related to the automotive business, but also we see new emerging application for the aerospace business. What is the Samica fireproof material? Is basically a prepreg which is manufactured from mica and silicon resin. Is used a resin which is catalyzed, so basically can be co-cured or co-bonded with traditional fiber-reinforced prepreg or composite parts. Because of the intrinsic nature of the mica, is resistance to fire above 1000 degrees and has also superior thermal insulating properties. This product is a product that starts from 4ALL while we use extracting mica from mines, and then our own land areas, which are in Brazil, and then is converted to a prepreg through a serious and consequent process of the mica, which also comprise the transformation of the mica in a paper, and then the impregnation of the paper with a silicone resin in a process which is very similar like the ones that we are very common for other industry. The products can then be cured and then can be shaped in parts that, as you see in this video, have very good fire barrier properties. The test was made in Riscoll according to ISO 26085 testing standard. So 4ALL here really relies on the long-last experience on extracting mica and sorting this and converting the mica in a paper. And here is really the paper part, which is really critical for us by controlling the chemical pulping and the composition of the mica. We are able to create a product that, although just relies on the Van der Waals forces to keep the product together, is robust enough to be roulette, and then to be used as the main and the only reinforcement for such prepreg. And then the impregnation process may occur with solvented resin, typically. And you see, for example, in this picture, some example of the final product. We see this real solution for some of critical aerospace application. So especially when it comes to fire penetration or to bound through performance or for acting as a fire barrier in general for interior or for structural parts. We have been developing prepreg, which may be very lightweight, down to 30 GSM, but can go up to 300 or 400 GSM. While cured, they have low water absorption, and they basically have a very inorganic content, which is quite uncommon for the prepreg or composite industry, because it's only based on 10-12% of organic parts, which is really giving the stability and the critical mechanical performance of the product, but at the same time is underlying the fire protection capabilities and the fire retardancy properties, which they really are key for some applications where we try, for example, combining or co-curing this prepreg with other fiber reinforced prepreg, curing a 180 Celsius degree. And we see, for example, in our test, then when this layer is used as a surfacing layer, this can provide 30% reduction on bar length, 30% reduction on the average heat release values. And in general, the ignition times is strongly delayed, and we see 2 times higher time to reach the typical peak of the heat release values during OSU, so basically heat release testing. So this is the end of our presentation. I hope you enjoy the slides. Feel free to contact us at aerospace@forall.com and follow us on Instagram and LinkedIn. And you can also see some contacts and the address of the our global group based in Switzerland. So, and I think now we have maybe 5 minutes time for question. And then I leave my colleague to help me on entry any question or comments or curiosity you have about the presentation.
Okay, let's start with the Q&A session. Now, we had a question regarding the core filler. Actually, it's two application questions. One is, can does this appear now? Let's see. And another one. How do I show this now? I'm sorry for the. Ah, okay, I just found that. Sorry for that. So regarding the core filler, can it be used as edge closing, as edge filling? I would say the answer is yes, it can. Fiorenzo, do you have something to add on this?
Yes, definitely. So this is a really well-known application for this material. I will say is primarily for edge close of the honeycomb structure, especially to prevent the water incoming, and also to give overall rigidity and output plane stability of the sandwich structure. Often very used application is for an internal part of the sandwich, where eventually we may want to insert some inserts and fastener to connect the sandwich part to any other part of the cargo, any other part of the cabin interiors.
And the second question regarding the application, to what thickness of honeycomb can we use our core filler?
We tried a half inch and 1 inch. And this is really the standard, let's say, thickness of the honeycomb used by us and I think in the industry. We don't see any specific limitation in general. We just need to rely on the ability to extrude the material very well and to fill all the cavities of the honeycomb. We have also different variants in our portfolio. Some of them are also very suitable for having a special thixotropic behavior. So then this will tailor really the flow of the material depending on the specific temperature profile and curing process by our customer.
Okay. We have a couple of questions regarding the mica. One very interesting one is this one. So what are the key advantages of mica fabric over the conventional fabrics? Maybe I can start commenting on this. Well, the mica paper is not the fabric. It's mica pieces are small plates that overlap each other, and by doing so form a layer which has no cavities, no holes. That means for stopping a fire, the same as actually stopping an electrical breakdown, this is why it's used for high voltage, is a lot better than glass or carbon. Even if the temperatures are not enough to melt the glass, but still the glass fabric has still some cavities where the fire can pass through. So it's not the fabric, it's a paper actually. Fiorenzo, do you have anything to add or should we go to the next question?
I think we can take another one.
Yeah. Maybe this one. Is it possible to add a coating on top of a mica layer to increase its fire protection? I don't think this is necessary because mica is completely inorganic. And just to bond it together, it's a very low quantity of silicone resin. So there's not really anything you can coat to make it even better. The mica itself is already the best fire protection, I would say. Could the mica be used as an external layer? Not really, no. This is a product which is quite fragile. That means it needs to be either co-cured as shown with a structural prepreg or with any kind of prepreg, or be used somehow sandwiched or encapsulated. So it's excellent against fire. It's a very good electrical insulator, but it's not the mechanically wear resistant part. Also, it's very, very thin. And for aerospace applications, we speak about just 30 grams per square meter. That means it's not really meant to be mechanically stressed.
Maybe one comment I can add is that, of course, once it's cured, the product itself will absorb a low quantity of water. We can judge in less than 1%. So it has not any mechanical performance, but it will serve as a surfacing fire retardant barrier.
We've got a very interesting question here. Whether you can compare this mica prepreg to a clay-filled polymer? Well, the answer is no, because in a filled polymer, the the mineral particles are completely distributed and not oriented. While in a mica paper, as we have seen in one of the slides, these small platelets are in perfect alignment. Otherwise, the mica paper wouldn't even hold together. So this really helps a lot for the fire barrier, because it really serves as a barrier and not just absorbing some heat. Maybe one last question. Can the mica be purchased as a prepreg to be co-cured with other resin systems? I would say the answer is yes, it can. Of course, need to be tested the compatibility of other resin systems. And so you have something to add on this?
No, we try actually with epoxy, and this was working very well. Of course, it can be purchased as prepreg and is actually handled as traditional rolls. So definitely we provide these on rolls. And from a product form standpoint, is very similar to any other prepreg used in the aerospace market. With curing up to 180 degrees as well. And compatibility with autoclave and not autoclave conditions.
Mm-hmm. And maybe a question, one very last question that goes into a bit the same direction. This one here. Would you comment on this?
I don't see really the question. Can you protect carbon composite from PAN oxidation?
Yeah, that's right, the PAN oxidation. But basically, yes, of course, it can be used to protect the carbon composites as a surface layer. Or maybe, Jack, you can be a bit more specific, but anyway, we have very little time left.
Yeah. Okay, I think we are too close now, because we are running over time. From my side, I thank you very much for your time, and we look forward to your question offline.
Good. Thank you very much, also from my side, and goodbye.